Hello everyone, my name is Avni Vaghela, nursing tutor at the Vinayaka Dinsha Patel College of Nursing, Nadiad. I am in the mental health department. My topic today I discuss about the crisis. So what is a crisis? Introduction of the crisis. A crisis differs from the stress in that a crisis results in the period of several disorganization resulting from a failure of individual using coping mechanism or the lack of usual resources or both. So first, what is a crisis? Crisis is different from the stress. Crisis is not a one kind of stress. In the crisis result in the period of several disorganization when the person or the individual are suffering from the any kind of problem in their life or in their situation, they causing a disorganization. Disorganization means a one kind of misorganization resulting from a failure of individual using coping mechanism where the person's life a person are suffering from any kind of disease, the disorganization occur in their life and they failure to solve this problem and they failure to using any kind of coping mechanism in their life, as well as they cannot use any kind of resources in their life, right? This called as a crisis. The different author give the definition of crisis according to the Taylor in the 1982. Crisis is a state of disequilibrium. According to the Taylor words, what is a crisis? The crisis is not a one kind of stress. As per we have to see in the introduction, right? Crisis is a state of disequilibrium. What is meaning of disequilibrium? Disequilibrium meaning disorganization or imbalance in the individual's life resulting from the interaction of an event with the individual's or the family coping mechanism where the person's life are suffering from the any kind of misorganization or the disequilibrium or the imbalance. The person cannot using any kind of coping mechanism and inadequate to meet the demands of the situation. Obviously, the person are suffering any kind of problem, they cannot cope with any situation. In this time, they cannot meet their demands, what they have to already knows, what they have to their choice, they cannot meet their demands or the situation. These all are the mismanaging situation combined and they causing the crisis in the individual's life. Family perception of the meaning of the event, right? Individual as well as a individual event as well as a family event, they all are causing any kind of a problem in the individual's life. They causing a crisis in the individual's life according to the Taylor in the 1982. Definition: a crisis is overwhelming reaction to the threatening situation. A crisis is one kind of overwhelming reaction. Overwhelming reaction means one kind of reaction in the threatening situation. Threatening situation means a difficult, worse situation in the individual's life in which a person usual problem solving strategies fail. Where the patient are suffering, where the individuals are suffering from the threatening situation, the person are usual problem solving strategies cannot use any kind of problem solving strategies, and this kind of crises occur in the individual's life. They resolve the situation resulting in the state of disequilibrium where the person cannot using any kind of problem solving strategies, they fail to solve the problem, and this situation, the state of disequilibrium occur in the individual's life. Disequilibrium is an imbalance in the individual's life, right? The definition is an overwhelming reaction according to the threatening condition. Threatening means a difficult situation where the patient or where the individual cannot using any kind of problem solving strategies, and these conditions are causing the disequilibrium in the individual's life. There are many types of crises in the individual's life, but mainly three types of crises we have to see in this. First is a maturation or the developmental crisis. Second is a situational crisis, or third is an advantageous crisis. According to their name, their meaning are the same, similar. तो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू मूव ऑन द मैच्योरेशन और द डेवलपमेंटल क्राइसिस. तो फर्स्ट इज अ डेवलपमेंटल क्राइसिस. डेवलपमेंटल क्राइसिस प्रिडिक्टेड टाइम ऑफ द स्ट्रेस इन द एवरीवन्स लाइफ विच अकर इन द रिस्पॉन्स टू ट्रांसमिट्स फ्रॉम द वन स्टेट टू अनदर इन द लाइफ साइकिल. डेवलपमेंटल सिंपल मीनिंग ऑफ डेवलपमेंट इज द नॉर्मल ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट इन द इंडिविजुअल्स और द इन द लिविंग पर्सन्स लाइफ. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल फर्स्ट बेबी बॉर्न टू दैट दे आर मेनी डेवलपमेंटल स्टेजेस. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल इन्फंट चाइल्ड टोडलर प्री स्कूलर दिस ऑल आर द स्टेजेस राइट इन द इंडिविजुअल लाइफ दैट इज अ डेवलपमेंटल स्टेजेस. सो द डेवलपमेंटल क्राइसिस इज एवरीवन्स लाइफ. Every person are suffering from the developmental crisis. It is a response. It's one kind of response in the transitional from the one state to another in the life cycle, where the person are transmit their age. They transmit in the one state to another in their daily life. This time the developmental crisis are occur. Developmental crisis also refers to the maturation or the internal crisis. Developmental crisis also known as the maturational or the internal crisis, right? Or developmental, as we have to say, the maturational crisis also says the internal crisis. This all other developmental crisis. Developmental crisis may occur at the any transitional period in the normal growth and the development. And normal growth and development are including in the developmental stages. So as per we say before, everyone's are suffering from this developmental crisis, right? In the developmental crisis, it is a transitional period where the individual move into the successive stage often generate the disequilibrium. Everyone's are suffering from the developmental crisis, right? But the some are move into the successively, but some people cannot handle this developmental state and they causes some kind of problems in the individual's life, and they generate the disequilibrium, this imbalance in the individual's life. In this condition, the developmental crises are occur in the individual's life. The individuals are required to make a cognitive and the behavioral changes that accompany development. Precipitating factor are a normal stress of the development. When individual are in the developmental stages, they have all kind of development are occur, all kind of changes are occur in the individual life. For an example, cognitive or the behavioral changes, right? These all are including into the developmental stages, but some kind of factors are causing us stress in the individual life, and these stress are causing a crisis in the individual life. For an examples of the developmental stages that are including in the adolescence, retirement, marriage and the parenthood, these all are the different stages, developmental stages in the individual life at the time of birth to the death. So everyone are suffering from this kind of crisis in the individual's whole life. Then second is a situational crisis. What is a situational crisis? The name suggests their meaning, right? What is situational crisis? Situational crisis. It occur in the response to the sudden unexpected event in the person's life. According their name, any kind of situation, unexpected events or unexpected situation in the individual or the family life, that time the situational crisis is occur in the individual's life, right? The critical life event revolve around the experience of the grief and the loss. Where the patient are suffering from the situational crisis, they are a critical life event. Critical means a very bad life event in the individual life. And when the patient or individual are suffering from the situational crisis, they experience to the grief or the loss. That is meaning the one kind of loneliness in their own life. In this situation, the situational crisis are occur. For an example, a loss of a job, divorce, abortion, death of a loved one, severe physical or the mental illness, etc. These all are the example of the situation crisis when the person are suffering from the loss of job condition. They cannot solve this problem. This time of the situation crisis are occur. Then second is a divorce, abortion. As a mother, they lost their child. These all are the situational crisis examples, right? Then third is an advantageous crisis. Advantageous crisis, that is meaning what is an advantageous crisis? Advantageous crisis are not a part of everyday's life. It's not a part of everyday's life. They are suffering from the some time in their individuals or the community or the family's life. The first is a which kind of a crisis? They are a developmental crisis are every person's life. The developmental crisis are occurring in the everybody, but the advantageous crisis is not a part of the everyday life. They are unplanned and an accidental resulting in the traumatic experience. What is advantageous? So that is a unplanned. The development are the daily life. The second one is a situational that are unexpected. And the advantageous crisis is unplanned and the accidental resulting in the traumatic experience. When the person are suffering from the any unplanned or the accidental situation that is causing a traumatic situation in the individual's life, that time the advantageous crisis is occur in the individual's life. The examples of advantageous crisis that are a natural disaster. The natural disaster are unplanned or accidental and they causing a traumatic situation in the community or in the individual's life, right? That's why the natural disasters are including in the advantageous crisis. Natural disaster, war, hurricanes, floods, fire, earthquake, etc. Also, the advantageous crises are including the example like a crime of violence, child abuse, rape, assault, bombing in the crowded area. These all are, right? These all are occurring into the advantageous crisis. Thank you.
Okay. Myself, Runak Parmar. And I am a nursing tutor in the Insa Patel College of Nursing, Mental Health Nursing Department. Let's move on to the crisis intervention. First of all, crisis intervention refers to the method used to offer immediate short-term help to individuals who experience an event that produces mental, physical, and behavioral distress problem. Okay. So, crisis intervention, it is refers to the method to use, means it is help to offer immediate or we can say the short term help to individual who are suffering from or who have experience of such as event like an emotional event, mental, physical and behavioral problem. Okay, so anyone have mental or emotional emotional, mental, physical and behavioral problem event experience whoever individual is experience that type of event and through the crisis intervention, we can help the victim. Okay. So next, what are the goal of crisis intervention? Okay. So first goal is to decrease emotional stress and protect the crisis victim from an additional state. Okay. So first of all, through the crisis intervention, we can decrease the emotional stress and we can prevent the crisis victim from additional stress. Okay. Next, to assist the victim in organizing and mobilizing resources for support system. Okay. So, to assist individual whoever is a victim and organize them and support them in supportive system or in the form of supportive, we can help the victim. Then after, to meet unique needs and research a solution for particular situation. Okay, through the supportive system, we can provide the unique need whichever victim needed and reach a solution for the particular situation. So, for the achievement of that goal or to reach whatever the solution through the crisis intervention, we can help the particular victim. that precipitated in the crisis. Okay, whatever particular situation that create the crisis, we can create solution for that particular situation. Okay, so next, what is the aim of crisis intervention? Okay, so it is to assist the individual in recovery from the crisis and to prevent serious long-term problem. Okay, so the aim of crisis intervention is to assist, or we can say that help the individual in the recovery from the crisis and to prevent serious long-term problem. So we can recover the patient and prevent serious long-term problem, or we can prevent the further problem through the crisis intervention. Okay, so move on to the purpose of the crisis intervention. So first purpose is to reduce the intensity of an individual emotional, mental, physical and behavioral reaction to a crisis. Okay, through the crisis intervention, we can reduce the intensity of individual emotional, okay, and we can reduce the intensity of individual emotional, mental or physical and as well as behavioral reaction also to the crisis. Okay, related to crisis, we can reduce the intensity of individual. Second, to help the individual return to their level of functioning before the crisis. Okay, so with the help of crisis intervention, we can return the patient into the normal level, or we can say into the functioning level. So whatever the condition of victim before the crisis level, we can return or we can move that victim in a normal stage. Okay, now crisis intervention balancing factor. Okay, so first left side containing crisis good outcome and right side included crisis development. Okay, first we will see about the crisis good outcome, how we can create good outcome from a crisis intervention. Okay, so first, so perception of event realistic. Okay, so first of all, we have to understand that what is the reality of any situation or event. So first of all, we have to understand, we have to realize that what is the actual problem, what is the realistic condition of particular event. Then after, second point included situational support adequate. Okay, whatever the situational support, support from the family, support from the friend, or we can say support from the group. So according to situation, we can get proper support or not, that is directly create impact onto the crisis intervention, or we can say onto the crisis. Okay, if we get proper situational support, then after we can use the coping mechanism adequately. If we are use proper coping mechanism, there are different type coping mechanism, such as ego, self-esteem, self-actualization, aggression. So according to condition, which coping mechanism we are use, that is adequate, that is proper or not for that properly crisis, that is important. So through the particular usage of coping mechanism, so there is less chance to create a crisis. Okay, so first of all, we have to perception of event realistic, we have to understand the realistic event. Then after, proper support, adequate support according to situation we have to provide, and then after choose proper coping mechanism adequately. So at the end, we can get good outcome in a form of no crisis. So that is the one part of crisis which is included into the good outcome. So we can get good outcome from these three stage, through the understanding, then adequate support and properly coping mechanism. Okay, then move on to the crisis development. So crisis development, so how crisis will occur or how crisis will develop into further level. So first point is perception of event distorted. Distorted means in a wrong way. So first of all, if any victim distorted, means taking the event in a wrong way, that create and through that the second point, situational support in advocate. If we are if we are get the event in a wrong way, then after the situational support is inadequate. If a person do not get properly support from the friends, or we can say any group or the person, that create the situational support inadequate. Through the inadequate support and the wrong understanding of event, we can through that crisis will develop in more level. Okay, so third point is coping mechanism inadequate. If there is a lack of coping mechanism, then after not taking proper coping mechanism, that create a more crisis. Okay, so how the crisis is developed further? So first of all, perception of event in distorted, means in the wrong way. Then after, inadequate of situational support. And third, coping mechanism is inadequate. If there is a lack of coping mechanism, or lacking into the properly understanding of what coping mechanism we should use, that create a more crisis. Okay, so that is the two type crisis, how we can get good outcome, and what how the crisis development go in a further level. Okay, next, this is the area how we can reduce the crisis, and how the crisis will become more and more at different level. So first of all, that is the stress. If any victim has a stress, that create a anxiety among that victim. And then after usual coping mechanism ineffectively. Okay, so if coping mechanism is ineffectively in the anxiety stage, that create a two part. First of all, we move on to the upper part, that trial and error solution. Okay, so we advise, or we can say we also perform the trial and error solution. If we are conducting the solution through a trial and error solution, that create the severe anxiety among the victim. And because of that severe anxiety, that personality disorganization occur, and crisis is more developed into the victim. Okay, so if we look at it, the lower level, that new problem solution and support. Okay, if we are using new problem solving solution and support, that create reduction into the anxiety, or we can say that decrease the anxiety among the client, or we can say into the victim. And that create pre-crisis level into the functioning. So that move client from crisis level to the normal level, or we can say into the pre-crisis level. So through the problem solving solution and support, that decrease the anxiety, and we can move client to pre-crisis level, or we can say into the normal level. Okay, so move on to the phases of crisis intervention. So first stage, including assessment, perception of event. Okay, so first of all, first stage including perception of event, means understanding of the event, what happened that prompted you to seek help, and how are you feeling now, etc. So we can ask the patient such question like, what happened that prompted you seek help, why you need help, what situation make you further seek help. Okay, then after, we can also ask a question about, how are you feeling now. Okay, then after B, coping mechanism. So we can ask victim about what is the coping mechanism he is or she is use. That include, if we can ask patient about if he or she has a thought of suicidal plan, then after, what is the other plan, and what help you feel better. Okay, so we can ask victim about the what help you feel better, etc. Then after C, support system, with whom you live with. Okay, so we can ask victim about the what are the support system available for his or her. So with whom do you live with, who is available to help you, and who is most helpful. So we can ask that type of question to client. Okay, so that including mental status, and also we can go through with the previous history, identify client strength, and self assessment also the main point, including it to the assessment of the client. Okay, so various diagnoses such as first risk of self-directed violence, okay, patient mein hum self-free, then after chronic low self-esteem, okay, through the crisis, low self-esteem will create more into the client, then hopelessness and powerlessness generated, then after severe panic level anxiety, okay, anxiety will be created by the crisis, then after disturbed thought process and sleep deprivation means problem into the sleep. Okay, how we can plan an outcome into the crisis intervention? So first, assist the patient in setting realistic goal to return the pre-crisis level of functioning. Okay, we can assist, we can help the client to setting a realistic and understanding the actual goal and to return into the normal phase. Okay, then second, establish desired outcome criteria for the patient using the problem solving approach. Okay, so we can establish outcome criteria for patient using problem solving process. So we can solve the problem through the problem solving approach. That problem solving approach including generating different ideas. First of all, define problem, then how we can overcome that problem. So we have a two or three ideas, so evaluate and choose the best one option and implement and evaluate that that whatever idea we are included or we can perform for the solve the problem. So that is including into the problem solving. Okay, then implementation. So first, take initial step to make the patient feel safe and lower anxiety. Okay, so we can take the different step to make patient feel and safety, and we can say that to lower the anxiety of the patient client. Okay, then after, listen attentively and encourage the patient to discuss the crisis situation. Okay, so we have to listen attentively, we have to give response according to their talk, or we can say according to their explanation, and we encourage patient to discuss the crisis situation. Okay, so we have to encourage patient about whatever thought comes in his or her mind, they have to discuss with her. Facilitate the verbalization of through thought and feeling. So we have to advise and facilitate the verbalization of thought and feelings also. Okay, then third, use problem solving approach. Okay, so we have to use problem solving approach. First of all, we have to define, then after generating different ideas, select proper ideas and implement for the solving of the problem. And fourth, identify needed social support with patient input and mobility most needed first. Okay, we have to identify what need or what social support the client need, and we have to provide according to the priority. Okay, thank you.